Welcome to Caliente Topics. This is your daily tax webcast. I'm your host, Veronica Rosso from MNMTaxMan.com, and I have Patrick Rosso as well from MNMTaxMan.com. Good morning, Patrick. Happy Friday, and let us know what's the topic for today.
Good morning, Veronica. Thank you so much, guys. Another exciting webcast for all of our young real estate investors out there. These individuals are people I like to call the weekend landlords. These are the individuals that have a day job from Monday through Friday, but are precocious in their real estate investment and already have something in their portfolio. Let's talk about an example where we have one single family residence, and what's the schedule or form that we would file our and report our rental income and expenses?
Schedule E.
Excellent, very good. So carrying on this example, I am charging $1,000 a month for my single family residence for a total annual revenue of $12,000. But it's expensive carrying a house. We know that. We've got the property taxes, the insurance, the mortgage interest, which is deductible, the upkeep and repairs, sometimes HOA. We know pretty much every dollar that you spent on that rental property is a deductible item. Now, after I use my losses or my expenses to absorb my rental income, how much of those extra expenses, the overage loss, can I use and apply against my ordinary income?
$25,000 per year.
Excellent. All right. So now take it to year two. Mm-hmm. And now I got to sell my rates. And now I'm not making under $100,000. Now I'm actually making over $150,000. Tell me, what will that do in the year that I'm now, or my family is now, reporting annual ordinary income of $150,000 or more? What happens to that $25,000 loss?
Ooh. Something that you're not gonna like, but what happens is that you're not longer able to claim the losses in that year, so it just carry forward for the following years.
Very good. At 100,000 is when a phase out begins, meaning that you're not allowed to take the full 25,000, and that phase out slowly completes at $150,000 or above. And as she was mentioning, on the form 8582, there's a passive loss limitations carryover form. That's basically a worksheet that allows you to keep all of those excess losses that you weren't allowed to take in the year in question, keeps carrying forward. And it carried forward until one of two things happens. One, your income does allow you to trigger that amount so that you start taking some of those passive losses, or you dispose of the property. Right now, there's a big deal in what we want to do as far as putting properties into an LLC. Is it necessary to put a property into an LLC in order to deduct the common expenses of a rental property and take advantage of that $25,000 loss?
It's not necessary, but it is 100% recommended.
Oh, that's absolutely right. For several reasons, right? Beyond just protecting the property as a legal bubble between assets inside the bubble and outside the bubble, yeah, which is a very big reason why landlords like to put their properties into the LLC.
Yep.
But we had also previously talked about being able to circumvent the $10,000 SALT state and local tax limitation.
Yep.
By now having the LLC as the deed property holder, and of course the one reporting the rental income and expenses on the LLC's tax return.
Definitely.
With the property taxes being paid out of the LLC's account, now you have a vehicle in order for you to avoid a loophole, if you will, to avoid a certain limitation that affects a lot of high income earners, especially in the state of California, Arizona, and New York. Is that right, guys? Please, we gave you a lot of information, so we're going to kind of keep it tight today.
Yeah.
The quickest way for a quick answer is for you to use the comment box below. Please use it to give us your quick answer. We'll get back, quick question, we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Guys, no matter what comes your way today, no matter what obstacles or challenges you may face, you just need to remember one thing.
Give them hell.
Have a great day, guys. We'll talk to you tomorrow.